नमस्कार, वेलकम टू एडिदास किचन। माय नेम इज विजया एंड टुडे आई शैल बी मेकिंग पंजाबी स्टाइल कड़ी एंड लेट्स होप यू लाइक इट।
So let's look at the ingredients required for Punjabi curry. First of all, I have here onions cut finely, and I have put salt, chili powder, garam masala, and some sunti, that is salt powder, ginger powder, and I have mixed some besan in this, right? Chickpea flour. Then we have here about two onions cut thinly. We have here about 400 grams of curds, which I have added water to this and churned it. All right. We will also need here some jeera powder, about half teaspoon, methi seeds, fenugreek seeds, bay leaf, tejpatta, some kadi patta curry leaves, one green chili, or if you want more, you can add more depending on your taste. Then we have some hing powder here, asafoetida, and this is our ginger powder. All right, and of course we have salt, dhania powder, haldi, and chili powder. And finally, for garnishing, we have some coriander leaves. I'm adding mustard oil, which is sarson ka tel. In Punjabi cooking, usually sarson ka oil is used. So this is for deep frying our pakoras for the curry. So I put it on high flame. Now you have to ensure that the oil smokes, and after that we will put the flame on low and then start frying the pakoras. So now our oil is smoking. It's prepared batter. Please mind your hands, don't burn them. Oil has a tendency of spluttering. So yes, you want to be careful. When they are browned properly on both sides, incidentally, after the oil had smoked, I had reduced the flame, and I'm now frying on low flame. You can increase the temperature accordingly. If you feel that the oil is getting too cool, you can increase the temperature. Remove these pakoras on tissue paper so that the excess oil is drained off. We are going to go on to the next part of curry making. Oil is slightly warm. I'm using the same oil. The same oil. I've removed the extra oil from the frying of the pakoras, and now I'll be adding first of all the methi dana, the fenugreek seeds. And I should also add the jeera. Give it a little mix. Sliced onions go in next. The onions have to be browned well so that the rawness goes away. You know, I have my little take on the way I make the pakoda. I like to add kasuri methi. Just kind of crush it between the palms and add that to the batter. Also, I like to cut up some kari patta, add that too to the batter. Just my little take on it. I like the taste of kasuri methi and curry patta. At this stage, you may add curry leaves, dried red chili, and bay leaf. Taste.
bay leaf has a nice unique fragrance of its own and good taste.
Okay, so now the onions are as brown as we would like them to be. At this stage, I'll add a little bit of this hing and some ginger powder. I like to add ginger powder during summers when fresh ginger is not easily available. It serves the same purpose. Here I am adding half spoon haldi, about 1/4 of red chili. You can increase it according to how spicy you like your dish to be. Then we have coriander powder. Remember, I said I love coriander. I also love coriander powder. So yeah, I end up adding quite a bit. And we have our green chili here. We add that. And this is the buttermilk. I haven't added the salt yet. I'll do that in just a minute. Now this has to be allowed to boil. Okay, I'm sorry, I forgot to mention that in this buttermilk I had also added about a tablespoon of besan. The purpose is of course to thicken the curry. The besan helps to thicken the curry and give it some body, if you can call it that. So now the curry has boiled quite nicely, and as you can see, it is also a little thick now. That's because of the besan. I shall be adding the salt at this stage. About 1 spoon according to taste. Give it a good mix. You can now add the prepared pakoras to this. Now the pakoras will naturally soak up the curry and the flavor then comes in the pakoda as well. There we are. All the pakodas are inside. Having a good time, I hope. And then we add some garam masala. Curry tastes best, of course, with either plain rice or jeera rice. And of course, those who like curry can have curry as it is. Fill up a katori, fill up a bowl and have it. Right? So this is our curry ready now. So now the curry is ready. It is best had with jeera rice. And here we pour this over the rice. Thank you for watching the video.